It really checked all the boxes, right? I mean, we have a stable iPhone business. We have growing ASPs, as Josh mentioned, and it was, you know, quite a number at 19% year over year. Services business growing over 30%. It's at almost a $40 billion run rate. You know, we have a nice capital returns program and a good outlook. So, yeah, a lot to like in the quarter.
In terms of what you need to see in the next quarter, that's going to be where we're going to really try to understand what's happening, I assume. Maybe not. But when it comes to these three new phones that people expect, when it comes to potentially the rollout of other services around content in terms of subscriptions, what are you looking for?
Sure. So the guidance was actually fairly good. And Apple's been known over the years to, quote unquote, sandbag guidance and to bring down expectations to beat them. And again, so they're guiding around 17% growth, which is similar to what we saw in this quarter. So for them to come in at or above that, of course, is going to be important. But we're coming into a new iPhone launch, 12th generation, as you mentioned, and some content creation with Oprah coming down the pike at some point here with a new subscription service. So number of things to be watching. I think obviously ASPs is still on everyone's mind and services are still on everyone's mind. It's becoming a growing feature to the story now with Apple.
Does the story ever we keep asking the question, does the story ever get re-rated? Meaning the Apple story was once a growth story,
right.
Then it became a value
right.
story. In terms of who the investor base is and how they're thinking about it and what the multiple should be applied on this company.
Right. No, that's a great point. And it's something that was not getting much conversation. You know, 2 years ago when Apple stock was under $100, everyone looked at Apple as purely a hardware company, something like a Dell that deserves maybe a 10 PE ex cash, which is where it was at the time, which never really made much sense to us. And now what we're seeing is, to your point, a re-rating upwards. One, because growth has been re-accelerating. We've seen seven straight quarters of accelerating top and bottom line growth. And two, because if Apple's going to become more of a software and services business that have higher margins and more recurring visible revenue, and they don't have to just continue to keep people on the hardware treadmill, then maybe a PE in the high teens is more appropriate as opposed to the low double digits, as I mentioned. So that re-rating story is in effect, and it's a lot of the reason that we've seen Apple more than double over the past 2 years, in our view.